Hi there, Eric Bakker. Thanks for tuning in again to the video. We're doing a series on Zonulin, a protein made by the small bowel, which will help to, control the permeability of the small intestine. So how do you reduce Zonulin levels? How do you get these levels down? Well, basically, you get them down by trying to avoid gluten and also by trying to clean up the gut. So if you've got any microbial imbalances there, if you've got some bad bacteria, you need to eradicate those guys. If you've got low numbers of beneficials, you need to bring them up. If you've got candida levels, you need to work on the candida. If you've got parasites, you need to get rid of them. So a study I read recently showed not much difference between the Zonulin, if it was high or low, and a GI disorder. And remember, many people with GI problems don't necessarily have to have strong symptoms to have that problem being there, because these symptoms can also be peripheral in other parts of the body. Meaning some candida patients may only experience brain fog, not actually have bloating or gas going on, So just remember that. So if you're in doubt, get a stool test done or some kind of analysis of the gut to determine what shape your gut is in. Because if you want to reduce Zonulin, you need to know first what the health of the digestive tract is like. If you're eating gluten, go on a strict no gluten diet for several months to see if it makes a difference. You can get a blood test done to determine if the Zonulin's gone down in response to taking gluten out of the diet. If it hasn't, you need to go further and deeper, deeper into it and have a look at the bacteria in the gut. You may have some Klebsiella or Citrobacter or Pseudomonas, or, there could be Proteus there. There could be some bug there in high amount or imbalance, creating a spanner in the works, especially if there's inflammation going on in the gut at the same time, which you will find, So reducing Zonulin basically means taking gluten out of the diet, cleaning the diet up, getting the levels of bacteria back in their place again, and that should make a big difference to Zonulin. And hopefully also, seriously help to reduce your risk of a lot of different diseases. Thanks for tuning in, and I hope that answers your question on Zonulin.